Hello, it's John, your pronunciation and accents coach, and right here you can get a better British accent. Today we're looking at the Sussex accent, that is the traditional Sussex accent.
The main source of information for this video is the Dictionary of the Sussex Dialect by W.D. Parish. The book is available to download as a PDF from Google Books. The link is in the description. Now, here's a question. How would you say
ladder and adder in the traditional Sussex accent? Watch the video to find out. Plus, if you're interested in other counties' accents, then I've already done a video on the Kent accents.
If you'd like to watch it to compare the two counties. So let's start with the Sussex fact file. Sussex is quite a large county that is actually divided into East and West Sussex. The county town of Sussex is Lewes, and the capital is Chichester.
In fact, I was born in Horsham in West Sussex.
Another famous town in Sussex is Brighton, which in ancient times came under different spellings, such as this. Still, today it's pronounced Brighton. Now, quick note about the Sussex vocabulary, where there are literally hundreds of examples of such words like drink, which is a medicine for cattle.
I gave the old cow a drink last night and she's up again looking ever so much better this morning. According to the dictionary, Sussex folk have a great imagination for creating words or expressions that are similar to the original. So, for example, brown crisis is bronchitis.
Okay, so now we are going to talk about the Sussex accent, which has all but died out, with features from a book written in 1875. Bear that in mind. In this first part, let's focus on the vowel sounds. Here we can divide the sounds into what we say in standard Southern British English, standard, which is what I'm speaking now, and what the Sussex pronunciation of those vowels was, traditional. Here's a summary of the best of Sussex sounds.
So, A before double D becomes R, whereby ladder and adder are pronounced larder and arder. A before T is expanded into EA. So, rate, mate, plate and gate are pronounced reet, meet, pleat and geet.
Here's an example sentence. At this reet, I'll need to get up the larder, up to those pleats meet. Double E is pronounced as I in such words as sheep, week, called ship and wick. And the sound of double E follows the same rule in filled for field.
And thus, mice, hive and dive become meese, heave and deave. So you might say, the meese are going from the field to the heave, so mind the ship. Okay, yes, you heard it here first.
And now let's look at the consonant sounds using the same key as the vowels. Double T, so a T sound, is always pronounced as a D sound, as little for little and butter for butter. So you might say, I'm going to pick some potatoes and have them with butter. The TH is replaced by a D. Thus, the becomes D and these, them and theirs become D's, them and theirs. Finally, just like the traditional Kent accent, the traditional Sussex accent was rhotic. This means that people would have a pronounced R sound after a vowel. So you might say something like, look, there's a shark in the water over there. That would be pretty unusual, I know, in Britain, but you never know. And now the modern Sussex accent, a brief overview. I would say it is pretty similar to the situation in Kent, where there is a good deal of received pronunciation, standard Southern British English, and estuary English spread throughout the county, depending on which part you live in and which class you are from. Have a look at my other videos on these accents, link is in the description. So I hope you enjoyed this video, and I hope you now know a lot more about the Sussex accent than before. So the question is, are you from Sussex, or do you know anyone from Sussex, or do you want any other accents for me to have a look at, please leave the comments in the chat. Remember to subscribe to the channel, and that's all for me today. Over and out. See you later.